ship car to chase down Iron Horse number 3. But for the time being, it's all fenced in.
No problem. I'll tear that fence apart.
The metal's too resilient for my bombs or your muscle. No, for this job, we are going to have to rely on a stronger force. The love of a mother for her child.
You got something to tell me?
Yes, I've had the good fortune of locating 2 juvenile bear cubs. If you put them together inside that fence, they'd surely start fighting. Bears at that age are particularly antisocial. Noise from the squabbles should bring their mother around to free the angry youths.
I get ya. That big mama bear will be able to smash the fence no problem to free her cubs.
That's correct.
Beware, cubs, for you are hunted by the Murray.
What's up, Bentley? Here comes Iron Horse number 2. You and that RC chopper of yours ready?
We'll get the job done, provided I can catch up with that train! That better work. Slime won't stand a chance making it through this train unless I neutralize the aerial defenses. Good thing I outfitted the RC chopper with a new cannon. Let's see. The X button drops bombs and the square button shoots forward. I should bomb those missile launchers before things get ugly.
Catastrophe!
Thank you.
You might not have time to jump on top.
Relax, Bentley. There's more than one way to get on top of that caboose.
The other clockwork lug should be hooked into the engine's furnace. Sneak your way up there and grab it.
Okay, guys, this is it. Time to break into Iron Horse number 3 and carry away the clockwork stomach. Now, the train's moving too fast to jump onto here in town, so we'll have to catch up with it on Murray's new handcar. Once we're in position, Sly'll hop aboard and make his way up to the engine. While he travels through the interior, I'll provide air support with my RC chopper. I've planned this as a textbook train robbery. If we all do our jobs right, what could possibly go wrong?
Hop aboard, guys! We've got a train to catch!
Got it. Strong work, Murray.
Yeah, sure. The Murray's strength knows no limit.
You're on, Sly. Break into that train and steal the clockwork stomach.
That John Basson's one strange guy. The claw gang divides up the clockwork parts and he walks away with the stomach and lungs? It still creeps me out.
Get creeped out later when we aren't riding an antique handcar at breakneck speeds.
Good point. It's time for a train robbery. Thank you.
nobody getting past me. That there clockwork stomach is as safe as a snowman in winter. I'd like to meet the varmint that's been looting my iron horse trains. By Jiminy, I get hot neath the collar just thinking about how I cut that boy down. I'd kill him like a spotted owl. I sure would.
Hey, Cooper! Varn might find you here. Just can't stay away from these clockwork parts, can you?
Oh, I just do it to meet exciting ladies like yourself.
If you'd like some excitement, why not climb up on top of the train? I'm sure to get your heart pumping, maybe even show you my new ride.
No thanks, Neela. I've seen enough already.
What's the problem, Poodle? Afraid you can't take me on? Have to call up your little friends for help.
Come in, little friends. Neela's got me pinned down. Any chance of air support?
I've already launched the RC chopper. She won't know what hit her.
Come on, Cooper. Let's play. What in blazes? All right, little RC friend. This should be a quick bit of destruction.
That was some fancy flying, little friend.
Whatever you say, Poodle.
Hey, Sly! Get to that clockwork stomach fast! This old handcart is starting to fall apart!
Thank you.
fast! This old handcart is starting to fall apart!
Looks like John Bassan's wised up and bolted the stomach down. We'll have to crack the engine block to get it free.
Then that's just what we'll do. A well-placed bomb down the train's smokestack will knock it loose. Just make sure to take some cover.
Not so fast, chum. The clockwork part is mine. They will all be mine.
I've got an upset stomach on my hands, but other than that, I feel great.
The gang and I had pulled off the impossible. We'd successfully robbed all of John Bassan's iron horse trains, and we were walking away with three, count them, three clockwork parts. And as a bonus, we shut down spice distribution in all of North America. Needless to say, we were pretty pleased with ourselves. Can't say the same for Carmelita. Once again, the framed policewoman had a run from the cops. Which was fun at first, but I'm starting to feel a little sorry for her. I mean, what if they replaced Carmelita with someone else? I don't want another cop on my tail. She's a big part of why this is all fun. Sooner or later, I'm gonna have to figure out a way to clear her name. Some way other than turning myself in.